In terms of the big takeaway, what makes localization pipelines work more effectively?
What makes the difference and what makes for a very more successful deployment to multiple markets is if you see localization as an integral part of your pipeline. And that's a shift in mindset for many development teams, but it's something that can really help to maximize quality, reduce risks and delays.
A key part of building localization into the process is standardization. Can you talk a little bit more about that?
So what we try to do is to help clients standardize the way that they manage their user interface strings, their UI labels, and that enables us to do automation. So we can extract strings automatically, reintegrate them. If they're in a standard format, we can maintain consistency much more easily. We can do analysis that finds anomalies and surfaces any potential bugs before they cause problems downstream.
And Julia, from an operational perspective, how does that translate into best practices for clients?
So the key points are having a Git repository to enable the push and pull of the full file sets is key. Without those full file sets and an easy push pull mechanism, it becomes a cumbersome process. Context is king. Our translators can't deliver good quality translations without context. It is so important. And often overlooked is actually the financial admin. We work with our clients to ensure that how we manage POs fits seamlessly into the process as well. So it's not just about the technical details of localization, it's actually also about the governance of the finances. And my final point is that there needs to be the appropriate sponsorship within the client and for them to provide that support